Okay, guys, today we will discuss about the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. See, what is this Consumer Protection Act of 1986 and why this act or enactment is passed by the central government? See, every country have all the public or all the citizens, all public or consumers only. One way or the other way, we buy the goods and services. And when we buy the goods and services, the seller, the manufacturer, they may sell their goods or services with an inferior quality, with an inferior quality of goods and difference in the quantity and difference in the prices, and the goods which may be injurious to the human being, injurious to or dangerous to the property of the consumer. See, for the various reasons, the consumer, he buy the goods, and when he buy the goods, the central government of India or the government of India should safeguard the interest of the consumer. So, in order to save the interest of the consumer, the Consumer Protection Act of 1986 came into existence. Now, what this act will do? So, first, under this act, we should define who is a consumer. Say, consumer is a person who buy or purchases goods and services for his own consumption but not for sale. See, it is very clear, if you are a consumer buying goods for your consumption, then you become a consumer. If you are buying the goods for sale, then we don't call him as a consumer. Next is, what are the objectives of Consumer Protection Act? See, everyone should know, every enactment will have an objective. Why this enactment came into existence? The enactment came into existence. So, the objective of a Consumer Protection Act is to protect the interest of the consumer. See, the Consumer Protection Act, it is the main objective is to protect the interest of the consumer. What is the interest of the consumer? Consumers should be supplied a quality goods, good quantity goods at a reasonable price, and there are various the goods which should not be harmful to the consumer and his properties. See, there are various interests are there. All such interests has to be protected by the Consumer Protection Act, and that is one of the objectives. The second objective is to protect the rights of the consumer. See, in India, not only in India, every part of the world, consumer is the king. Consumer is the sovereign. Because if we don't buy, no manufacturer, no sellers can sell the goods. Am I right? So now, what are the such rights for a consumer? See, right to safety. What is right to safety? Right to safety is nothing but the consumer expects such goods from the manufacturer or seller which is not harmful to him or to the consumer or to their property. So that is one of the right to safety of the consumer. Like that, right to be informed. What is right to be informed? The consumer should be informed about the details of the product. Details of the product and how to use it. And all the information regarding the products or goods and services should be properly informed. Next is right to choose. What is this right to choose? See, the consumer should have alternatives to buy the goods and services in the market. A seller or a manufacturer cannot impose, a seller or a manufacturer cannot force to the buyer to buy his products. So buyer should have every right to choose what he wants or what she wants. Right to be heard. What is right to be heard? If the consumer is affected with any goods or services, and if the consumer go to the Consumer Protection Act, the Consumer Protection Act should hear the problems, hear the grievances of the consumer. So therefore, even the consumer has got a right to hear, right to get redress. Once if the consumer is affected with some problem and he has to file a complaint with the Consumer Protection Act, and the Consumer Protection Act should redress, resolve the grievances or problems of the consumer. Even that right also he has got. Next, right to consumer education. Unless and until if the Consumer Protection Act does not provide proper education to the consumer, what to buy, what not to buy, why we have to buy, at which price we have to buy, all these things. So every consumer has got a right to inform to the production, I mean Consumer Protection Act to educate them. So that's why you can see most of the television, you will find the advertisements, this don't pay more than the MRP price, and they say, one of the right. So, idana to protect the rights of the consumer, ee point ge illa helibidini. Okay na? Next, to protect the consumer against unfair trade practices. Unfair trade practices means what? If the seller is practicing any unfair practices, selling the prices at a higher value, selling the goods at the inferior quality, selling the goods with the damaged goods, selling the goods which are hazardous to the human being, which are dangerous to the human being, all such unfair trade practices, this Consumer Protection Act will have control on all sellers and manufacturers to avoid unfair trade practices. Next is to set up Consumer Protection Council. See, why we have to set up the Consumer Protection Council is, if the consumer comes with a complaint and if he got affected with any goods or services sold by a seller or a manufacturer, then the consumer complaint has to be made and that complaint has to be resolved or redressed. So these redressing of his complaint will be handled by the Consumer Protection Act by setting up the councils. This is the fourth objective of what? COPRA. Next is to provide education to consumer. Already we have discussed here. Now let us come to what are the different redressal agencies which will act on behalf of the consumer or which will protect the interest of the consumer. Say whoever the consumer go with a problem, go with a loss or loss by using the goods or services, he can go for getting the justice either in the form of compensation or in the form of getting a new good in place of a old goods. New product in place of old product, he can approach the Consumer Protection Act. Now, the Consumer Protection Act has established three agencies. How many agencies? Three agencies. One is a district forum. Second one is a state commission. The third one is a central commission. See, these agencies, what they will do, see, at the district level, in every district level, you will find one Consumer Protection Act managed or established by Consumer Protection Act as a district forum. See, sometimes if more number of complaints from the consumer, even more than one district forum will be formed in each district. Now we should understand how this district forum will act and how this district forum will get justice to the consumer. How they will get it? See, the district forum is consisting of composition is nothing but in this district forum there are totally three people will be there. These three people will always take the complaints from the consumer and they will handle the complaint and they will try to redress or resolve the problems of the consumer. Now, who are those members? See, first member is one president should be there. This president should be a district judge. This person should be a district judge and remaining two members will be there. In those two members, one member should be woman. One member should be compulsorily woman. See, what is this qualification? What is their knowledge? See, they should be well versed with economic laws and public affairs. And they should be integral. They should be honest. They should be sincere. Such members will be appointed as a members. Who will going to appoint president? Who will going to appoint the members? See, both president and members are appointed by the state government, appointing a selection committee, forming a selection committee, and the state commission head or state commission president will be the one of the member of the selection committee in order to select the members and the president of the district forum. So totally state government will be forming this or appointing this president and members with the selection committee, forming a selection committee. See, what is the duration? See, the president and members will be in their position as a president and members in the district forum at least for 5 years or up to 65 years, whichever is lower. That means a member or a president can be president or members for 5 years. Suppose if age is more than 65, or if age is 65, then he will get retired. Suppose if age is below 65, then he can work maximum for 5 years. And this president and members can be reappointed once again, once if their term is over. Now, jurisdiction. Now, consumer, if I have a complaint against a seller, then to whom I have to approach? To whom I have to approach? See, I can approach on the basis of the loss or damages I am seeking from the opposite party seller if the damages or compensation amount is less than below 20 lakhs, then I can go and file a complaint with the district forum. Understood? Now, the district forum will handle only below 20 lakh rupees of compensation complaints. Only below 20 lakh compensation things. Next is procedure of complaint. What is the procedure of the complaint? Now, the consumer, he should write if the complaint is grievances on a piece of paper, and he should mention his name, address, phone number and everything, and he should give what is the problem or what is his grievance and from whom he got that affected. That is opposite party, the seller's name, address and all the details has to be furnished, and it has to be submitted to the district forum either personally or by post. So this is about the procedure of complaint handling or complaint taking. Once if the complaint is taken by the district forum, okay, the same copy of the complaint given by the consumer, it has to be sent it to the opposite party or the seller. Once he sends the, what is that, complaint to the opposite party or the seller, he will wait for, that is district forum will wait for 30 days, okay, to get the reply from the seller or the opposite party. Suppose if the seller doesn't give any reply within 30 days, we give additional 15 days to get the reply. Suppose if any goods which is sold by the opposite party or seller which is harmful, which is affected to the consumer, then the district forum will go directly to the manufacturing unit of the seller, they collect the samples of the product and they will send it to the laboratory. From that laboratory, they will get report within 45 days. The maximum period of getting the reports is 45 days. After looking at the report, that report will be sent to the opposite party stating that, see, the products what you sold is consisting of so many chemicals. Because of this chemical, the consumer got affected, and please give the explanation. Now, the opposite party should give what response or answer to the report, laboratory report. If he does not reply for the laboratory report, then the government, the district forum will go with the powers. They use their powers. See, that is what we have to understand. See, after sending the laboratory report, if the opposite party doesn't give any reply, then the district forum will exercise their powers. Now, what are the powers of the district forum? See, the powers of the district forum. The powers of the district forum. I will tell you. I have posted this, but still, once again, I repeat it. See, the powers of district forum, it has, the district forum has the power to issue notice to the opposite party, number one. It can pass an order to the opposite party to replace the defective goods with the new goods. It can direct the opposite party to pay compensation to the consumer for the loss happened. Even the district forum can advise the trader to stop untrade practice. And district forum advise the trader to not to sell hazardous or dangerous goods. The forum also has power to enter the trader premises or a seller premises and seize the defective goods. See, these are the some of the powers. If using all these powers, the district forum will give a judgment against the opposite party, stating that you, if you don't pay the compensation or if you don't pay the compensation to the consumer, then you will be imprisoned at least for 30 days to 3 years and penalized with the 2000 rupees to 10,000 rupees. Sometimes both penalty and imprisonment will be there. In case if the opposite party is not satisfied with the judgment given by the district forum, then they can appeal to the state commission. From the date when the judgment is given, within 30 days they can go for state commission for the appeal. See, this is about the district forum. Now, whatever we understood in the district forum, you will find the similar things, okay, similar steps, okay, for state commission as well as central commission. Just quickly I will read it out, okay. Now, let us understand what is state commission. The state commission is also composition of 3 members. In that, one person will be the president, and that president should be high court judge. The president should be high court judge. Again, 2 members will be there. In that, one member should be woman, and they should have a good knowledge of economics, laws and public policies and public affairs. And they should be integral, honest, sincere and all those things. Okay. Appointment. Who will going to appoint the president and members of the state commission? Is the state government of India will appoint, form a selection committee. In that selection committee, the central commission will be one of the main person to select the members and the president in the state commission. The duration for them is, for the members and the president in the state commission, is 5 years or 67 years, whichever is lower. See, for example, if I am a 50 years old, if I am a 50 years old, I can serve for 5 years, that's all. Suppose if I am 64 years, to reach 67, how many more years are there? Only 3 years are there. Then I can be here only for 3 years, because after 67, I will get retired. So that is what? 5 years or 67. In case of district forum, 65 years. Here it is 67 years. Now, what is the jurisdiction for these people, for the state commission? See, the state commission, they handle with the complaints having a compensation value of more than 20 lakh rupees and less than 1 crore rupee. That means the volume amount of compensation should be 20 lakhs to 1 crore. More than 20 lakhs, less than 1 crore. That means if a consumer is suffering with the or having a problem or a grievance with the compensation of 20 lakhs to 1 crore, they need not to go to district forum, they can directly go to the state commission. All we got it? If it is less than 20 lakhs, then they can approach the concerned district forum in which district the buyer or the consumer is living. Next is procedure handling is complaint will be same. The buyer should give a complaint in writing. Either personally he can go or he can send someone to file the complaint, and he should mention all his details and the seller's detail, name, address and phone numbers and all. So that is remain same, and the treatment of the complaint also will be same. The complaint copy given by the consumer, send it to the opposite party and expecting what is that? Reply from the opposite party within 30 days. If he doesn't, opposite party doesn't reply, then we give 15 more days to get the what? Reply. Suppose if the goods is very dangerous goods, if he is handling, then the state commission members will personally go to the sellers or manufacturers or traders manufacturing unit. They collect the samples and send it to the laboratory. That laboratory report will be receiving within 30 days of the submission of the samples, and such sample report will be sent to the opposite party. We expect, see, this is what is happened with your goods. The laboratory report says so and so chemical, so and so good is not, it is hazardous or dangerous to the consumer, and you are manufacturing this. Please give the explanation. So, if the opposite party does not give any explanation, even after sending the laboratory report, then the powers will be handled. The state commission will, what? They will act with their powers. So, same powers, whatever I did read in the district forum, they will have a same powers. Next is penalty, also same, and appeal. Within 30 days, they can go. If the state commission is given a judgment, and if that judgment is not satisfied with the opposite party, the opposite party can go to the central commission within 30 days from the judgment. Now, let us come to the central commission. The central commission, the composition overall will be there in the central commission. There will be totally 5 members will be there. In that one person is a chairman. The chairman is a, should be a Supreme Court judge. A chairman is a Supreme Court judge. And this chairman will be appointed by the Chief Justice of India. Who will be appointed? Chief Justice of India. The remaining 4 members will be appointed by the central government. Central government forming a central government committee. And from these 4 members, 1 member should be compulsorily woman. So, this is about the composition and appointment. Okay. Now, jurisdiction. If any complaint having a more than 1 crore rupees of compensation value, then you can go directly to the central commission, need not to go to state and district forum. And procedure for handling, same to same. Treatment of complaint is same to same. Powers also will be same to same. Penalty also will be same to same. But appeal, in case if any judgment given by the central government and if the opposite party is not satisfied with that, he can go to the Supreme Court. He can go to the Supreme Court within 30 days from the verdict passed by the central commission. Got it, sir? Sir, this is a very, very important. Now, what is the meaning of consumer dispute? What is the meaning of complaint? What is deficiency? I will tell you. What is consumer dispute? See, consumer dispute is nothing but if a consumer is facing any problem with the goods or services consumed, which is supplied by the seller, then there will be a dispute. Complaint. Complaint is maybe in writing, which is submitted by the buyer to the redressal agencies. Deficiency. What is the deficiency means? Deficiency means when you are using a good or a service or any product, if you find any deficiency in quality, quantity, purity, all these things, then such things are called as deficiency. Sir, from this chapter, you will get 1 compulsory question for 14 marks. That is, you may be asked to explain the redressal agencies, any 2 are from this. And they may ask you for 6 marks, what are the rights of a consumer? Or they may ask you, what is consumer dispute? Who is a consumer? What are the objectives of Consumer Protection Act? So these things. If you have anything, please put me, please write in my comment. So that I can give you any reply if you want, any answers if you want. Thank you so much.